At sinasabi pa ng ikalawang pagbasa, the speech of Peter to Cornelius. Peter is telling about the baptism of the Lord. That in the baptism of Jesus Christ, his mission was really proclaimed. He healed the sick. He expelled demons. He gave liberty to captives. Diba? Yun ang sinasabi ni San Pedro to Cornelius. Nakapaloob ang mission ng ating Panginoon. And even in the gospel today, Luke's account of the baptism, it's the same thing. It started with John the Baptist. People are looking up to John the Baptist because all they know, etong si John the Baptist, he might be the Christ. Diba? Siya yung boses sa desert na sinasabi. And he will prepare the way of the Lord. No? He will straighten the path of the Lord. How? The mountains will be straightened. It will be flattened. The valleys will be flattened. And what are these? The mountains of our pride will be flattened. The valleys of our anger will be flattened. The valleys of our own selfishness will be flattened. So that when that Christ comes, Christ will come in a straight path. Yun si Juan Bautista. So akala ng maraming tao, he might be the Christ. But John the Baptist is so conscious about it. Sabi niya, no, I am not. Ano sabi niya in Luke's Gospel? I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I will come. He will baptize you with fire and the Holy Spirit. Diba? Buti na lang si Juan Bautista, very conscious about it. In another account of the baptism, he says also, I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. So alam niya that he is not the Christ. Diba? And then comes the baptism of Jesus. In Luke's account, the baptism is already finished. Tapos na. But in another account of the baptism, we really see Jesus, you know, lining up with the people. Imagine natin na si Juan Bautista ay nagbabaptized. Ang daming nakapila. Diba? And Jesus lined up with the people. Maybe for the early church, that is a scandal. Why? Ang pagbibinyag ni Juan Bautista po ay pagbibinyag dahil sa kasalanan. John baptizes for the repentance of sin. Eh bakit si Jesus? Walang kasalanan. The sinless line up with the sinners. It is a scandal. John the Baptist, in another account, says also, I cannot baptize you. Diba? Sabi niya kay Jesus, hindi kita pwedeng i-baptize. You should baptize me. Eh bakit si Jesus lined up to be baptized by John? You know why? Jesus Christ wants to show to us His oneness with humanity. I am one with you. Nakikiisa ako sa iyo. Sa iyong kababaan, ako ay nandoon. Sa iyong kahinaan, ako ay nandoon. At hindi ako mahihiya. I will not be ashamed to be one with you. I will not be ashamed to be with sinners. I will not be ashamed to line up with you. To be on your lowly state. I will not be ashamed. Wow. Jesus Christ, sinless at that, lined up with us. At hindi lang po yun. After lining up, he was baptized by John. At ang baptism po nun ay nilulubog sa tubig. Naranasan yun na bang malubog sa tubig? Yung bang pupunta ka sa ilalim ng tubig, ang dilim at bigla kang iaangat at ang makikita mo
liwanag.
It's very, very, you know, meaningful to be baptized in that way. Why? Because as if nilubog ka sa dilim ng kasalanan, pero iaangat ka muli sa liwanag ng ating Panginoon. And that is the same experience of the baptism of Jesus. He is one with us. He is not ashamed with us. And therefore, para tayo ay maligtas, siya din ay bumaba sa dilim para lahat tayo ay maiangat niya sa totoong liwanag. Wow! Siya ang ating Panginoon. Nakikiisa sa atin. One with us in our own weakness. Hindi tayo kinakahiya. That of what? As if in the very bottom of our heart, for those people who are crying out, Lord, be with me. Lord, stay with me. From the recesses of our heart, saying, Lord, here I am, weak and lowly, wounded. And yet Jesus, the sinless, the pure, comes and then says to us, I am with you. I am one with you. Nakikiisa ako sa'yo.